I'll be showing you how to make mouth-watering gulab jamun at home from scratch. For making this gulab jamun, we need 1/2 cup of self-rising flour. If we don't have self-rising flour, I'm going to show you how to make one. For 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour or maida, we are using 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder. So we are mixing it together to make the self-rising flour. 1 cup of milk powder. I'm using organic non-fat dry milk powder. Around 1/2 cup of light whipping cream. For making syrup, we need 2 cups of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon cardamom powder or 5 to 6 cardamoms crushed into powder, a pinch of saffron or kesar, around 3 1/2 cup of water, oil for frying. First we will prepare the syrup. So I am adding this 2 cups of sugar,
water,
and I am going to keep this on medium high for boiling.
Once this sugar syrup starts boiling, I am going to add cardamom powder and this saffron and reduce the heat to medium low and let it boil for 5 minutes. Now it's been 6 minutes. I am going to turn off the heat and keep this aside.
Making the self-rising flour, so I am adding this 1/2 cup of maida or all-purpose flour, 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder, and mix really well. And now I am adding this milk powder and again mix well to make a jamun mix.
Now the mix is ready. I will be showing you 2 different ways to make the jamun dough. One is we are using a whipping cream to mix it. Another way is we are using a tablespoon of ghee and a little bit of milk to mix and make the dough. I am dividing this mix into 2 parts, and one side I am making it with a whipping cream and another side I am adding a tablespoon of ghee and then mixing it with whole milk to make a dough. I am
taking a tablespoon of ghee and putting it to this half of the side. Mix it well.
Now I am mixing this ghee side mix with a whole milk, adding little by little at a time. To get the right consistency, we need a little less than 1/2 cup of milk or whipping cream to mix this dough. The consistency should be like this. The dough shouldn't be very hard.
I'm going to show you with this whipped cream. So same consistency. Just add this whipped cream and mix it.
If you are using a heavy whipping cream, let the dough be little bit in a harder side so that you'll get a best jamun. It has become the same consistency of the other dough.
Jamun dough is ready. So I'm going to make balls. Meanwhile, I'm going to heat up the oil for frying these jamuns.
Take a small amount of this dough and make it into balls. And this size we can make around 30 to 35 jamuns, or you can reduce the size and make more.
We will make these balls and keep it aside until this oil heats up.
Now the oil is hot enough. To check it, add a little bit of dough into that oil. It has to come up immediately. Now the oil is ready. We are going to add this jamun balls. Fry these jamuns on a medium low heat until it becomes golden brown color. Now our hot sugar syrup is ready and jamuns are turned golden brown color. I'm going to take this out and transfer it onto a paper towel, and before transferring it to a sugar syrup, let it cool for some time and repeat the same procedure for the remaining dough. Now these jamuns are cool enough. I'm going to transfer this to a hot sugar syrup. Let it soak for 4 to 5 hours. And if you want, you can refrigerate it. Our delicious gulab jamun is ready now. I hope you enjoy making.